If you don't get it, it's always going to be weird, always going to be surprising, always going to be shocking, always going to be strange, always going to be slightly horrific. And I think that's really the story that I think is the persistent one. You know, some people get it, some people don't.
Tattoo designs, modern examples of an age-old custom which has literally left its mark on mankind. They're on show at one of Britain's oddest institutions, the Bristol Tattoo Club. It's a men-only club, men who really have let this form of art get under their skin. Each week they meet and show each other new designs they've had tattooed on their bodies.
I don't get it. I don't get why people would want to do things like that to their body.
Some of the tattoos are real works of art, but there's nothing arty about the men who wear them. Since the days of primitive man, who was tattooed with a picture of his first lion kill to prove his coming of age, tattoos have remained a sign of toughness.
Small tattoos are okay, you know, discreet ones, but it's when they're covered from head to toe. Wah bam bloom bam 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 to the boot, oh boot.
And in a way, tattooing iconography hasn't changed a huge amount, right, in 350 years. It's names, things of love, patriotic symbols, things of the sea, patterns, flowers.
I used to call it multicolour discrimination when they wouldn't let you into a club or a bar because you had tattoos.
Before, if you see someone with a tattoo, you stood back a little bit and thought, now. Nothing.
Tattoos are seen now as being more cool as opposed to being kind of bad, like a bit like the old days kind of thing. Because back in the old days, it was mostly was it bikers and people with strong political beliefs.
You know, there was a time when you had a tattoo, you were a thug, you weren't to be associated with. But these days, I said, look around, everybody. And you'll have one before you go on, won't you, Max? We'll get you in a chair.
We really are talking about a change that has happened within the last 30 years, and that's not a huge amount of time to completely change, you know, social attitudes. You know, it's about the same amount of time that we've seen the women's movement, the gay and lesbian movement, which is only now, if we want to compare it to the gay and lesbian movement, which is only now really getting traction, you know, in terms of things like, you know, marriage equality and that kind of thing.
Half of us are into the tattoo history and tradition, and half of us are into the rock star and sort of want to be seen.
Tattoo is becoming much more visible, and actually now also, in the past sort of 10 years maybe, there's lots more tattoos on hands, necks and faces, which I don't think are acceptable yet in a general sense. I think you're still gonna struggle to get a job in lots of professions if you're as visibly tattooed as I am. But certainly it's the case that you see tattoos a lot more now than you didn't before.
The Reaper, baby, can't kill me.
Can burn me?
You can shoot me, but you just can't kill me!
It's kind of come around quite a bit. You know, when I'm out in public, I can just enjoy, you know, walking around. And instead of the mother grabbing her child and going, the monster, she's like, hey, my daughter loves your tattoos. Can she touch her? The experience is becoming, it's so prolific, so that I can just relax, except when I go through customs. No, I'm just kidding.
Whether it's become more accepted, more mainstream, a little bit. It's true that over the years, there's been more and more, let's say, professional people who come and get a tattoo, you know, nurses, doctors, lawyers. There probably was some in the past, but they were not showing it, you know. So you could say a little bit, but whether it's really generally more accepted, I'm never gonna buy that one. There's always gonna be a large part of the population who finds tattoos
I think people do, in a lot of areas, people would judge in parts of London or outside, you know, that aren't so like liberal, maybe, and haven't got such a mix of people. And I find it funny that, like, my friend who's covered in tattoos, he, you know, elsewhere people will look at him a lot because he's got some piercings as well. And then as soon as, like, he'll walk into Camden, he's like, you know, he's just, no one would even bat an eyelid because he's surrounded by, you know, his people.
Maybe if you're from a wealthy background, you're more inclined to be discouraged to get a tattoo, probably.
It's changed so much. It's not like, you know, before they had, like, you know, just one kind of people. Now, you know, everyone is getting tattoos, so.
Yeah, most of the people I know have had them from young, really. There is a few that's got them in their 50s, but it's just like one, like, say, on her hand, like my missus has got one on her hand.
I like being tattooed young. Former rebellion, it was fun, even in a kind of loose traveller hippie community. When you're a little kid with a couple of tattoos, they kind of do a double take. I'm like, what? Aren't you a bit young?
Well, I got my first tattoo in 1973 when I was 13.
The first time I went in a tattoo shop, I was 13. I had to wait because it's obviously illegal, so I had to wait and got my first tattoo.
Since I was 15.
In 1969, we had the Miners Act come out where you couldn't be tattooed unless you was 18, so of course we all lied about our ages and that. And he didn't know we were 18, although he might have done, you know. But.
When I was 22.
I was 17 years old. It's when tattooing was illegal in New York City. It was inside an apartment in a very small room with many frightening looking men. And I was one of them.
2021. I came into them fairly late in life and they became a personal part of my identity.
I had my first tattoo when I was 40. It was just something to do when I was 40. And I've actually got three tattoos of species that I'd like to have as pets, but you can't.
What does it mean? Why did you have it? And the one I have is actually chemical hazard sign. That's what you do when you're 22.
One's a bat, one's a dolphin, and one's a seahorse.
It's a permanent reminder that I've got a lovely wife and I've got two lovely daughters. And that's every time I look at it, it reminds me of them.
It's an art form that's communicated not through big institutions. It doesn't really often have much of what we might call an avant-garde. And so people sort of see it on other people, they like it, and they get it done. And they think, this is what, you know, this is the kind of tattoos I should be getting. And so there's this kind of tattoos I will get, right? So there's a kind of commonality of tattooing.
I had mum and dad there and a swallow, and I had the same here with my name and a swallow, and that was £5. There were £2, £2, and 10 bob as it was, 50 pence each.
They pinpoint a moment in history that when I'm old and grey, I'll be able to look at them and think, oh well, that was fun, that maybe wasn't so good, but it's done, and it's my own picture collection.
As a youngster, it's more rebellious, that's what I'm going to get done, and it was one of them, I know I shouldn't be doing it, but I did. But these days, I think it's just individuality, that's me and that's what I like and that's how I look.
Some of them mean something and some of them, like, just scribbles on my skin, so.
I don't know if you can put a big, deep meaning to any of it. They all had their moment. They're all souvenirs. I have tattoos from friends.
A lot of people have said to me over the years, Paul, you know all the best tattooists in the world and you've got all rubbish on you. And they say, why is that? And I say the same thing, is because I only get tattooed off people I like. And I've been tattooed by members of my family and people who's never tattooed before because I just want the mark. To me, the tattooing is more of a mark than an actual picture. It's like I've got tattoos of ex-wives and things like that. They mean more to me than what an Ed Hardy piece would mean, even though I'd love to have a big Ed Hardy piece. But you know what I mean? I'm more in it for the history and the memories. Who's running up for you?
Yeah.
I have a various different tattoos. Like right now, I've got these. I drew these and gave them to the artist to have them put on me. It's basically like a good side and an evil side. And then on my left forearm is my son's footprint. And then my right arm is literally all the bands, different bands that I listen to. And then the one I'm getting today is, it's a Ninja Turtle back piece, because that was my childhood. So that's basically what I worshipped as a kid.
I think that, you know, the younger generations today, you know, Y and Z, whatever we're looking at today, it's a very different world that they have to choose from, both in terms of designs and in terms of discourse. They're not living in a world where, sure, they have to tell their parents about their tattoo, and that's, you know, always a bit of a negotiation, but they themselves aren't making decisions based on a connection between a design and a culture, or a design and a stigma. They're just picking designs.
And for most intents and purposes, in other academic disciplines, tattooing is a phenomenon, right? So it gets written as, you know, why would you do that to yourself? And then a whole kind of squeeze, whole books about tattooing, you know, all tattooing as a kind of phenomenon, right? Every tattoo is the same phenomenologically. Whereas from like our historical point of view, and almost from a common sense point of view, someone hand poking themselves with, as my old bus driver did, a Wham logo, and someone traveling to Switzerland to see Philippe Lou to get a whole back piece done, they're not the same thing.
And have you noticed how many ladies go for full decoration now? They go for the lot. Back, front, legs.
They're using all these tattoo models to advertise big retail companies now to get people's attention. Like, people see it like, oh my God, that's so cool, I'm going to shop there, and that sort of thing. So I think they use it to their advantage now.
Oh, the hard sell is on, and has been for a while. Do they all like the tattoos because the television told them to? Or are they just feeling like it's okay now because the TV said it's fine? Because people have always liked, there's always been a certain amount of people that get tattooed. Maybe a few people now think, well, it's popular, mum won't kill me, I think I can do it. That's my defense, it's you know, J-Lo did it or something like that.
Cheryl Cole's got a backside, I mean, yeah. You know, when you see high profile people like that, it takes the stigma away from having a tattoo.
People look up to them, so even me, I look up to Rihanna. I like her tattoo. She has a lot of hand tattoos, and I think that's really cool.
There's a lot of people, youngsters now, with sort of black and grey sleeves, following the style of David Beckham.
David Beckham gets a sleeve of black and grey clouds and angels. Suddenly, most artists have had several people come in saying, oh, can you fill my arm up the same as David Beckham? It does create fashion, and there is fashion within it, but then there's fashion within everything, so you just have to accept that.
Anybody in the public eye is going to be affecting the fans, the people who follow them, so it's a snowball effect, isn't it, you know.
Some people love tattoos, some people don't. You know, it's just something that I've always found that I kind of express how I'm feeling or the thoughts that I have or, you know, or memories, which most of my tattoos are memories and things that mean things to me.
While on the field with Beckham, we noticed he was sporting a tattoo. Wow. Altogether, he has 15.
My wife.
That's your wife?
Yeah.
Casey? Till death do us part?
Yes.
When David Beckham handed off his jersey, it made one six-year-old summer vacation.
Qui mieux qu'un footballeur ou un chanteur connu peut démocratiser quelque chose? On a bien vu l'histoire, enfin, ce qui s'est passé avec Beckham quand il avait son bras qui n'était pas tout à fait fait, mais qu'il a commencé à le remplir. Il y a plein de gens qui venaient nous voir pour oui, je veux un bras style Beckham, plein de trucs noir et gris, machin.
Lots of people do get tattooed for fashion. You know, or they're influenced by the media, things they see in the media. And in the end, I just think that you're going to find a lot of companies that make lasers are going to be selling a lot of them.
You know, it's hard to explain, really. It's why people get it and why people do it, because it's not pleasant for me getting them done, cool. It puts my teeth on edge even when I get a little tattoo now, you know. I think, what am I doing here?
I think I have learned that over all these years, that the main drive we all have is the desire to be tattooed. Design comes in secondary, absolutely, because there are multiple choices at every turn that would suit just fine. What should I put on my elbow? Flower, you know, cloud, wave, they're all good.
It's like, I guess it's like going to a gallery and looking at, you know, paintings on the wall. It's no different.
You can have a painting, you can put it on the wall. If you don't like it, you can take it off. It's not so important. If you've got a tattoo, it's on your arm. Like we say, you can take it off, but it's not as simple as taking it off the wall.
The images themselves, there are whole books about tattooing, academically about tattooing, which have nothing in them about the images, right? Where these images come from, where they're produced, how they relate to broader visual cultures, and actually what them being tattooed on the skin does, right, as a process.
Some of the tattoo artists, I'm not saying every single one, but a lot of them are also art and are also practicing art on other media, on canvas, on paper, on whatever.
If we're going to take tattooing seriously as an art form, then we have to kind of understand it as an art form outside of these kind of contexts. You know, it can't just be art if it's hanging on the wall of a museum.
Toute la difficulté d'une exposition sur le tatouage qu'on se veut sérieuse en fait aujourd'hui, c'est que c'est une histoire qui a été cachée et qui a été transmise que de tatoueur à tatoué ou de tatoueur à tatoueur. Donc notre travail, c'était aussi de creuser, de faire remonter tout ça et de pouvoir le présenter à un public qui est plus large et ne connaît pas du tout ce monde-là.
I think with the art thing is kind of interesting because obviously for many years, I mean, from originally Ed Hardy was trying to make it be recognised. He wanted it to be recognised as the art form that it is. You know, drawing these designs, it is a fantastic art form that takes a long time to perfect. Then there is actually the craft and the method of actually applying that ink into the skin. That's a separate art form in itself, more of a craft maybe.
Well, the fine artists are dominating more and more of the field. And I shouldn't say the fine artists, but at least people, tattooists who represent themselves, you know, as fine artists. And certainly it's becoming more and more normative for us to expect that.
Right across the board, the people that are getting into it, that would not have wanted to go into a scary shop in the bad part of town, you know. Now they can go to the nice part and find a very open, colourful, art-based tattoo studio, which there were few and far between before.
They were like postcard things, weren't they? Mum, Dad, Death or Glory, daggers, skulls, that sort of thing. But these, I mean, the portraits my bro there does are fantastic, so lifelike. And I'll say all around you, they're fantastic. It's great artwork these days.
It's carrying someone's artwork, you know. They're all like little Picassos or little Dalis or... And as I say, it's just knowing that someone has worked on you and you can take that work away and it's on you forever.
Because when I first got into it, it was more like, how can you say, stamps? It was like Love Arts, Anchors, Eagles. But to me, that's always tattooing. I mean, I love the new stuff today, but to me, it's not really tattooing. It's more of an art form.
Because tattooing has become so much more popular, there's a lot of more people, a lot of really good artists who just got into it, and I think it's such an amazing thing to kind of, you know, join your artistic skill with tattooing.
Le monde journalistique et le monde analytique regarde maintenant le tatouage, enfin j'espère, regarde le tatouage comme un véritable objet de recherche, c'est-à-dire un véritable territoire qui invite vraiment à l'investigation. Voilà, et qui ne soit pas qu'une investigation, on va dire, d'ordre de la sous-culture, c'est-à-dire à regarder avec un peu de dédain et beaucoup de recul, mais de comprendre en fait que toutes les valeurs qui sous-tendent le tatouage sont aussi très explicables d'un point de vue intellectuel et scientifique.
What was ours is now everybody's is a bit of a paradox for me. On the one side, it's really cool, man, and groovy, you know, it's like, great, wow, I can just walk around and be invisible. Oh, wow, nice tattoos, brother, cool, no biggie. That's a groovy, that guy's had kind of a groovy life, that old guy there, that guy over there. And then on the other hand, it feels a little bit manipulated, a bit contrived, a bit stolen.
There's certainly still a more challenging aspect to tattooing, and it still can be used in a more challenging way. I mean, there's a reason why gangs still use it, and why police departments track it, because it is still super effective. It's still super effective as a way to mark one's identity in a group, whether that group is something that is inclusive or whether that group is something that is outside of the norms of mainstream society.
Being able to separate yourself from the group, this is me, that is one major motivating factor. And funnily enough, that's what I wanted at first. By the time I had my second tattooing, I wanted to belong to the tattoo family. So I went from wanting to be totally, you know, separate to wanting to be part of the group, all in two tattoos.
I grew up around probably the nicest people on earth, and they were tattoo artists. My uncle, he's actually the tattoo on my calf. He passed away in 2009. He was a tattoo artist. And he was, if you ever approached him, he was one of the nicest people on earth. He'd give you the shirt off his back if he could. So the whole stereotype, tattoo artists, people with tattoos, they're evil, they're dark. No, probably some of the nicest people you'll ever meet.
It'd be interesting to see, you know, in 30 years time, when a filmmaker goes to talk to a young tattooist who's then an old timer, to see their views on things and to see where tattooing is in the future and artistically where it's gone, you know, because it is on the up. It's amazing, but it's interesting to see.